Our lecture today is about cell injury and cellular adaptations, presented to you by Dr. Rasha Abdul Rauf Safi. The objectives of this lecture are the definition and type of cell injury, the causes and mechanism of cell injury, explain the various mechanisms of cell adaptation to injury, necrosis and its type, apoptosis and its mechanism. Definition and types of cell injury. Cell actively interact with their environment, adjusting their structure and function to accommodate changing demands and extracellular stress. Usually the intracellular environment of the cell is highly regulated, that it remains fairly constant and in a state known as a homeostasis. So the cell can encounter the physiological stress, which like increase in the workload in the heart or potentially injurious condition like nutrient deprivation, and undergo in a state of adaptation, achieving a new steady state and preserving viability and its function. And if the adaptive capability of the cell is exceeded, so the cell injury will develop. Within a certain limit, the injury will be reversible and the cell can return to their stable baseline, but if the stress is severe, persistent or rapid in onset, it results in irreversible injury and death of the affected cell. So the cell death is one of the most crucial events in the evolution of the disease in any tissue or organ. The cell death can result from many causes like ischemia, which means lack of the blood flow, infection, toxin, and immune reactions. Cell death also is a normal essential process in embryogenesis, as we will explain later on the development of organ and the maintenance of homeostasis. This is a figure or show how the cell can accommodate according to the injurious stimulus and the sequence of reversible cell injury and cell death. At the first, the cell is in normal homeostatic condition, in a state of a balance in between inside and outside extracellular environment. And if there is injurious stimulus, its cell will adapt itself to this stimulus, and if the adaptation is exceeded and the cell cannot accommodate this stimulus, it will enter in a state of reversible cell injury. If the stimulus or injurious stimulus is removed, the cell will return to normal state. If the stimulus or the injurious stimulus is hard and sharp, the cell, and severe progressive, the cell will enter into irreversible cell injury, and it may pass into cell death, which is either necrosis or apoptosis, and later on we will explain the difference. The causes of cell injury: we have the hypoxia and ischemia and toxins. We have infectious agent, immunological reaction, genetic abnormalities. All these you can read it carefully. Nutritional imbalance, we have a physical agent and aging process. Sequence of event in cell injury and cell death. Reversible cell injury is the stage of cell injury at which the deranged function and morphology of the injured cell can return to normal if the damaging stimulus will be removed. In reversible injury, cell and intracellular organelle become swollen because they take in water as a result of failure of energy-dependent ion pump into the plasma membrane, leading to inability to maintain ionic and fluid homeostasis. In some form of injury, these organelle and lipid may accumulate inside the injured cell. The morphology of reversible cell injury: we have two morphological main morphological correlates of reversible cell injury are cellular swelling and fatty changes. In cellular swelling, it is commonly seen in the cell injury associated with increased permeability of plasma membrane, and this is difficult sometimes to be appreciated with the light microscope, but it is often apparent at the level of the whole organ. When it affects many cells in an organ, all the organ will be pallor or get pallor, as a result of compression of the capillaries, increased turgor, and an increase in the organ weight. Microscopic examination will show a small clear vacuole within the cytoplasm. These represent distended or pinched off segment of the endoplasmic reticulum. This pattern of non-lethal injury sometimes semi-hydropic change or vacuolar degeneration. All these changes are detected in a cellular swelling. In case of fatty changes, it is manifested by appearance of triglyceride-containing lipid vacuole in the cytoplasm, and it is principally encountered in organs that are involved in lipid metabolism, mainly liver. طبعاً the cytoplasm of the injured cell أيضاً become eosinophilic, يعني لونها أحمر تأخذ الصبغة الحمراء of eosin during the staining, a change that become much more pronounced with the progression of necrosis. Other intracellular changes associated with cell injury هي plasma membrane alteration مثل blubbing, planting, or distortion of the microvilli and loosening of intercellular attachment. Mitochondrial changes, swelling and appearance of phospholipid-rich amorphous densities, dilation of endoplasmic reticulum with the detachment of ribosomes and dissociation of polysomes, and a nuclear alteration with the clumping of the chromatin. The cytoplasm contains myelin figure, which is a collection of phospholipid تشبه المايلين sheath that are derived from the damaged cellular membranes. At the point of no return, احنا هسه بالreversible injury. At the point of no return, when there is a persistent or excessive noxious exposure, the injured cell will pass to a point of no return and undergo cell death. Although there are no definite morphological biochemical correlate of irreversibility, but it is characterized by three phenomena. معناته the irreversible state of cell injury and the three criteria. أولا inability to restore mitochondrial function اللي هو oxidative phosphorylation and ATP generation. اثنين loss of the structure and function of the plasma membrane and intracellular membrane and loss of the DNA and chromatin structural integrity where injury to the lysosomal membrane result in enzymatic dissolution and release of the enzymes, digestive enzymes when the cell are injured they die by different mechanisms depending on the nature of the severity and the severity of the insult. When we have a severe disturbance like loss of oxygen and the nutrient supply and the action of the toxin, all these cause uncontrollable form of cell death, necrosis or accidental cell death. The morphological manifestation of accidental cell death or necrosis in Greek necros يعني death. Necrosis is a major pathway of cell death in many commonly encountered injuries like those resulting from ischemia, exposure to toxin, various infection and trauma, and it is considered as a result of severe damage. In other words, necrosis happens accidentally because the injury is too severe to be repaired and many cellular constituents fail or in contrast B, if we have injury is less severe or the cell need to be eliminated during normal process, during embryogenesis for example, they activate a precise set of molecular pathway that end with death. Because this kind of cell death can be manipulated and controlled and used as in a therapeutic agent or genetic mutation, it is said to be regulated cell death. The morphological appearance, يعني اللي نشوفه على الخلية, morphological appearance of most type of regulated cell death هو apoptosis, نسميه apoptosis. In some instances, regulated cell death show feature of both necrosis and apoptosis, فنسميه necropoptosis. The idea of regulated cell death raised the possibility that specific molecular pathway can be targeted therapeutically, وهذا البنفت مالته انه it can be controlled فنقدر نستخدمه بالtherapeutic pathway to prevent loss of cell in pathological condition. So apoptosis كتعريف it is a process that eliminates the cell with a variety of intrinsic abnormality and promotes clearance of the fragments of the dead cell without eliciting inflammatory reaction. الأبوتوسيس هو عكس النكروسيس. بالنكروسيس يصير عندنا damage to the membrane of the cell, leakage of the digestive enzymes and failure of oxidative phosphorylation due to the damage of the mitochondrial membrane. فيسوي لنا فد inflammatory reaction عكس الأبوتوسيس. الأبوتوسيس the membrane will be intact still, although the cell pass an apoptotic pathway, but the apoptosis does not elicit an inflammatory reaction due to absence of the damage to the membrane. So it is a clean form of cell suicide occur in pathological situation when the DNA of the cell or a protein are damaged beyond repair, or the cell is deprived of the survival signal. Unlike apoptosis, apoptosis is an indication of healthy tissue, يعني can occur in healthy tissue, while always the necrosis is an indication of pathological process. It serves يعني apoptosis to eliminate unwanted cell during normal development and to maintain a constant cell number, so it is not necessarily associated with pathological cell injury. These types of physiological cell death also called the program. It is important to point that cellular function may be lost long before the cell death occurs. يعني احنا نفقد الفانكشن during cell death قبل لتظهر المورفولوجيكال ابييرنس whether necrosis or apoptosis على الخلية الميتة. اذا الفانكشن يفقد قبل لتظهر المورفولوجيكال changes. For example, in myocardial cell death, it becomes non-contractile, تفقد الكونتراكشن مالتها after 1 to 2 minutes of ischemia. بعد الستيمولس of ischemia تفقد الفانكشن after 1 to 2 minutes, but it may not die until 30 minutes of ischemia have elapsed. يعني الموت يحدث بعد نصف ساعة, لكن loss of function يحدث بعد 2 minutes. Morphological features indicative of death of ischemic myocyte appear to be by the electron microscope within 3 hours after the death of the cell, but are not evident by light microscope until 12. Now we come to the necrosis. The necrosis is a form of cell death in which the cellular membrane fall apart, يعني الممبرين يتدمر, and cellular enzyme leak out subsequently, and ultimately it will digest the cell. Necrosis يسوي لنا host reaction اللي هو inflammation مثل ما عدنا وكررنا, which induced by a substance released from the dead cell and serve to eliminate the debris and start the subsequent repair process. Necrosis often culmination is the culmination of reversible cell injury that cannot be corrected. يعني معناته irreversible cell injury ممكن ينتهي بالnecrosis مثل ما وضحنا بالفيجر السابق if the cell cannot get rid of the stimulus or adapt itself. The biochemical mechanism of necrosis vary with different injurious stimuli. The mechanism of necrosis includes failure of energy generation in the form of ATP because of reduced oxygen supply or mitochondrial damage ممكن يصير. Damage to the cellular membrane including plasma membrane, lysosomal membrane, lysosomes تحتوي على digestive enzyme which result in leakage of cellular content and enzyme. Irreversible damage to cellular lipid, protein, كل محتويات الخلية it will be damaged, and the nucleic acid which may be the caused by the reactive oxygen species and others. What are the morphological features of necrosis? We have two types of morphological features, اللي هي cytoplasmic changes and the nuclear changes. In the cytoplasm, راح نشوف there is increased cytoplasmic eosinophilia. شنو معناتها appear cytoplasm appear deeply pink in color than normal cell. هذا the cause of this is due to increased binding of eosin الصبغة الحمراء اللي نصبغ بها النسيج to the denaturated cytoplasmic protein, and also due to loss of the basophilia that is imparted by the RNA in the cytoplasm. احنا قلنا the content of the cytoplasm start to be degenerated and damaged. من ضمن الكونتنت هو الRNA in the cytoplasm, المسنجر RNA and other RNAs type. All these will give a bluish color to the cytoplasm. So when there is a loss of the RNA from the cytoplasm, only the stain will staining the cytoplasm هي الإيوسين. بعد الهيماتوكسيلين ما تصبغ الجينيتك ماتيريال, اختفت من السيتوبلازم فتبقى فقط صبغة الإيوسين, لذلك راح يبين more pinkish during staining. Okay, the cell may have a more homogeneous appearance because of loss of the cytoplasmic organelles than the viable cell, mostly because of loss of a glycogen particle. النيوكليار changes اللي نشوفها من necrosis هي 3 type. عندنا البكنوسيس اللي هي عبارة عن shrinkage of the chromatin material and shrinkage in the size of the nucleus and appear more condensed and become increased in the basophilia of the nucleus. الكاريوركسيس اللي هو بيكنوتيك النيوكليوس undergo fragmentation تكسر النيوكليوس والكاريوليسيس اللي هو تحلل النيوكليوس البيزوفيليا of the chromatin become pale secondary to DNA's activity انزيم الDNA يبدي يكسر الDNA داخل النيوكليوس وتبدي النيوكليوس to be faded. This is a figure showing liver cell necrosis in all its changes. عندنا الأبر ليفت سايد اللي هي النورمال نيوكليوس نسميها النيوكليوس واضحة النيوكليار ممبرين is clear and there is a nucleolus inside the nucleus and بهالحالة النيوكليوس نسميها vesicular nucleus. الحالة اللي أبر رايت اللي هي البكنوسيس تشوفون الكروماتين is condensed. The nuclear membrane is not visible. It is only a pycnotic nucleus, dark chromatin, clumped chromatin inside the nucleus, and the nucleus appears just as a dark spot. The karyorrhexis, اللي هو lower right, اللي هو starting the nucleus to be fragmented, والكاريوليسيس اللي هو lower العفو الكاريورrhexis lower left. Lower right الكاريوليسيس اللي هو تشوفون cells without a nucleus the nucleus start to be fade انتهت اضمحلت. What are the patterns of tissue necrosis? We have many patterns of tissue necrosis. First of all is coagulative necrosis characterized grossly by firmness of the affected tissue and microscopically loss of the cellular fine structural details but preservation of the basic tissue architecture. يعني احنا نظل نشوف الarchitecture present of the tissue لكن الfine details within the tissue is absent. Necrotic cell show homogeneously eosinophilic cytoplasm تبدي النيوكليوس تنفقد واللي يبقى هو eosinophilic cytoplasm devoid of the nuclei. Coagulative necrosis, this is a characteristic of ischemic damage in the solid organ. يعني coagulative necrosis is a criteria or type of necrosis affecting the solid organ except the brain. It has a special type of necrosis. So here, this is a gross appearance of the kidney infarction. تلاحظون grossly يبين the infarcted area as a wedge. Yellow to pale area, infarcted part, coagulative necrosis affecting the kidney in a wedge shape. هنا to the right side أو B هو microscopic view of the wedge of the infarct with a normal kidney اللي هي N pointed as N والinfarcted area اللي هي I. النكروتيك سيل شو preserved outline, outline مال necrotic tubules طبعا هاي tubules of the kidney. Preserved outline of the tubule with the loss of the nuclei. Nuclei كلها انفقدت باللينينج epithelium of the tubule. And there is an inflammatory infiltrate is present in between the tubule. Number two, which is the liquefactive necrosis, it is characterized by complete digestion of the dead cell, result in the transformation of the affected tissue into thick liquid. It is enclosed within a cystic cavity. من أقول cystic يعني تجويف. This type of necrosis is seen in two situations. A. Focal pyogenic bacterial infection. من يصير عندنا bacterial infection. البكتيريا start to liquefy the material and is frequently creamy yellow and نسميها pus. وبالischemic destruction of the brain tissue. هنا نشوفون gross appearance of the liquefactive necrosis affecting area. تكون wedge in shape and pale, soft and cystic. هنا البكتيريا liquefy the tissue of the brain and once it is dissected, the liquefied material or pus material sloughed out and leaving this cavity with a debris in the base of the cavity. Gangrenous necrosis, when we say gangrene, it is a distinctive pattern of cell death. Usually it is applied to the limb and mainly the leg that has lost its blood supply and has undergone coagulative necrosis. طبعا this type of necrosis involving many layers multiple layer and semi-dry gangrene. Then gangrenous necrosis is a type of coagulative necrosis affecting the lower limb or the extremities in general, and it involving many layers within the lymph and semi-dry gangrene. If it is have a superimposed infection, coagulative necrosis modified by liquefactive action of the bacteria, فرح نسمي wet gangrene. Calcaseous necrosis, this is a specific type of necrosis and very important, in which the tissue architecture is completely lost and the cellular outline cannot be detected, and it is encountered in foci of a tuberculous infection, a cellular رئوي. Caseous معناتها cheesy like material derived from friable yellow white appearance of the area of necrosis. The area of necrosis start to be appear like the cheese, gritty يعني محببة, white إلى yellow in color, and it has a friable appearance. Friable يعني هشة, من نجعصها بإيدنا مثل البيست, مثل المعجون. Microscopically there is a necrotic focus appear as a pinkish and granular in appearance. Caseous necrosis is often bordered, يعني تحاط الفوكس of necrosis by an inflammation. هذا هو هنا الgross appearance of two type, اللي هو gangrenous necrosis والcaseous necrosis. On the left side we have the gangrene of the lower limb. تلاحظون at the left side هو dry gangrene, اللي هو coagulative necrosis involving multiple layer. And the wet gangrene, اللي هو coagulative necrosis involving the lower extremities of multiple layer with superimposed infection. To the right side, we have a caseous necrosis, اللي هو in TB, in tuberculosis, affecting the lung with a large area of caseous necrosis containing yellow-white, تلاحظون الكلر, أصفر إلى أبيض, and cheesy debris, مثل من تتلمسوها مثل الجبنة. Cheesy جاي من الجبن, يعني تشبه الجبن. Fat necrosis, it is typically seen in acute pancreatitis and result from release of activated pancreatic lipase, enzymat pancreas tظهر, into the pancreas and the peritoneal cavity that liquefy the membrane of a fat cell in the pancreas. Grossly, ينطينا visible chalky white material, لأنه lipid يتحد ويا الكالسيوم, فينطينا chalky white material بيضة. Microscopically, foci of necrosis contain vague outline of the necrotic fatty cell with a bluish calcium deposit. طبعا ليش يعطينا vague outline؟ لأن lipid cells أو fatty cell هي بالحقيقة تحتوي على fat. فduring processing and taking many section and نضيف الفورمالين ونضيف الستين, هذا lipid يبدي يموع بالprocessing, فراح يترك only the outline of the lipid cell and the nucleus, وتظهر الفوسي of calcium deposit at the site of necrosis. B, عندنا fat necrosis seen in the female breast, ممكن preceded by history of a trauma. تجي الفيميل للكلينيك تقول أنا قبل أسبوع أو يومين أو ثلاث أيام انضربت أو تعرضت إلى trauma to my breast, traumatic fat necrosis نسمي. أيضا يسوي لنا damage to the fatty cell, وهذا الدمج أيضا يؤدي لنا إلى fat necrosis. So this is the cross appearance of area of white chalky deposit represent foci of fat necrosis with calcium soup formation. The process in semia saponification at the site of lipid breakdown in the mesentery. Fibrinoid necrosis, this is the another type. It is typically seen in immune reaction involving the blood vessels. There will be deposit of immune complex together with fibrin. This result in homogeneous bright pinkish appearance. Here, this is the histological section clarifying the wall of artery, which show in the wall of the artery circumferential bright pinkish. This a cool, مثل الياخة أو الحلقة, of bright pink area of necrosis with the protein deposit and inflammation darken nuclei of the neutrophil. This is the wall of the blood vessel. The center there is RBCs are present, and there is a necrotic area within the wall of the blood vessel. Apoptosis, this form of cell death is regulated suicidal program which is controllable, in which the relevant cell activate enzyme capable to degrade the cell on nuclear DNA and the nuclear and other nuclear and cytoplasmic protein. So the plasma membrane of the apoptotic cell remain intact, but it is altered in a such a way that the cell become a valid or a target for the phagocyte to be engulfed, and the dead cell is rapidly cleared before its content leak out, so it does not provoke an inflammatory reaction. The cause of apoptosis, either physiological, physiological or pathological, physiological during embryogenesis, اللي هو organogenesis and involution. Involution of the hormone-dependent tissue, like in the female during a female menopause, hormone deprivation will occur and start to cell to be to get in apoptotic state. While endometrial cell breakdown during the menstrual cycle, even regression of the lactating breast after weaning, بعد الفطام. Also in proliferating cells such as intestinal crypt epithelia to maintain a constant number. يعني شنو يعني مع crypt epithelial level بالintestine lining epithelium of the intestine start to be get apoptosis in the cell which lining the intestine in order to prevent increase in the number of the cell. When there is a shedding of the certain cell, it start to pass an apoptotic pathway. In cells that have served their useful purpose, يعني الخلية اللي تخلص شغلها وتنتهي دورها undergo apoptosis as a neutrophil in acute inflammation. In a pathological condition, apoptosis eliminates cells that are genetically altered. يعني أي خلية يصير بها genetic alteration أو mutation, it will pass an apoptotic pathway or the injured beyond repair without eliciting host reaction. The morphology of apoptotic cell in H&E, يعني منقول H&E يعني hematoxylin and eosin stained tissue section, the nuclei of apoptotic cell تكون show various stage of chromatin condensation and aggregation and ultimately karyorrhexis. At the molecular level, this is reflected in the fragmentation of the DNA into nucleosome sized piece. The cell rapidly shrink, form cytoplasmic bud, and fragment into apoptotic body that are composed of membrane-bound piece of cytosol and organelles. Because these fragments are quickly extruded and phagocytosed without eliciting an inflammatory response. So here we see the morphological appearance of apoptotic cell. Here the apoptotic cell اللي هي indicated by arrow in the colonic epithelium. هاي طبعا this is a colonoscopy and we take a tissue from the colonoscope and during the preparation some of the cell will become injured and pass into apoptotic pathway. So this is a procedure of endoscopy for preoperative or preparative regimen for colonoscopy. Induce apoptosis in the epithelial cell which appear in the biopsy اللي هي indicated by the arrow. There is a fragmented nuclei within the condensed chromatin and the shrunken cell body. تشوفون الخلايا تبدي يصير بها shrinkage وتترك space دايرها. Some of are with pieces falling off كأنما واقعة بالحفرة. هو بالحقيقة shrinkage on the size of the cell that leave a vacuole around. This is a table show the physiological and pathological condition of that associated with apoptosis. هذا انتو تقروا عليكم. This is another table comparison between necrosis and apoptosis اللي هو programmed cell death, both type of the cell death. This is important program table, sorry. What are the mechanism of apoptosis? Apoptosis it has a distinct pathway, a biochemical pathway that control the balance of death and survival inducing signal and ultimately the activation of enzyme نسميها caspase. يعني الخلية حتى تفوت بالapoptosis it activates certain type of enzymes that control the death process, the suicidal process. هاي الانزيمز نسميها caspases. Two distinct pathway of caspase activation. هاي الكاسبيس حتى يصير بها activation it has two pathway. We have the mitochondrial pathway and the death receptor pathway. The number one mitochondrial اللي نسميه intrinsic pathway seem to responsible for apoptosis in most physiological and pathological situation. اللي هي الميتوكوندريا contain several proteins that are capable of inducing apoptosis اللي هو mainly cytochrome C. هذا موجود داخل الميتوكوندريا. If the mitochondrial membrane become permeable, the cytochrome C will be leaked out into the cytoplasm, triggering caspase enzyme activation and apoptotic death will start. The death receptor اللي هو نسميه extrinsic pathway of apoptosis عندنا many cell surface molecule are present نسميها death receptor. High death receptor can triggering the apoptosis. Most of these are members of a tumor necrosis factor receptor family اللي contain in their cytoplasmic region death domain. Domain يعني part متخصص بقتل الخلية. So named because of its mediate interaction with other protein involved in cell death. What are the cellular subcellular responses to injury? We have autophagy. Autophagy يعني الخلية تأكل نفسها. Refer to lysosomal digestion of the cell own component. And we have induction of the hypertrophy of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The smooth endoplasmic reticulum is involved in the metabolism of various chemicals like drugs. We have mitochondrial alteration, also one of the subcellular responses, increase in their number in case of cellular hypertrophy or decrease in number in case of atrophy. An extremely large abnormal mitochondria, نسميها mega mitochondria, بالهيباتوسايت in association with a nutritional deficiency and alcoholic liver disease. We have cytoskeletal abnormalities, اللي هي cytoskeleton يشتغل as in the cell as a scaffold. Scaffold يعني مثل المجرفة اللي هي represented by myosin. شنو هي cytoskeleton؟ هي الميوسين. We have intermediate filament and microtubules. كل هاي يصير بيها abnormalities. Example of these is the alcoholic liver disease. Cytoskeleton نسوي لنا Mallory bodies. Mallory bodies, these are eosinophilic collection of intermediate filament اللي هي cytoskeleton that accumulated within the cytoplasm of hepatocyte فنسميها Mallory bodies. Although there are no definite morphological biochemical correlate of irreversibility, but it is important to be characterized. يعني any irreversible cell injury, the characteristic مالته three phenomena اللي قلناها بالسلايد السابق هذه إعادة هي loss of the mitochondrial function, unable to restore its function, اللي هو oxidative phosphorylation, loss of the structure and function of the plasma membrane, and intracellular membrane where loss of the DNA and the chromatin structure integrity. Cellular adaptation to stress. Adaptation, these are reversible changes in the number, in the size, in the phenotype. Phenotype يعني شكل, metabolic activity and function of the cell in response to change in their environment. ممكن هذا يكون physiological adaptation وممكن يكون pathological adaptation. The first adaptive response was hypertrophy, واللي هو عبارة عن increase in the size of the cell resulting in increase in the size of the total organ. My hypertrophy often and most likely comes in with another adaptive response, اللي هو hyperplasia, اللي هو زيادة في عدد الخلايا, increase in the number of the cell. But in a pure hypertrophy, لما يجي وحدة الhypertrophy, there are no new cell. ما راح تتجدد الخلايا, فقط زيادة بالسايز. Just bigger cell containing increased amount of protein and organelles. The hypertrophy occur when the cell have a limited capacity to divide. شنو معناته؟ We divide the cell of our body into three types of cell according to their capability to divide. We have the labile cell, the cell which are continuously divide, اللي هي the cell of the epithelial cells, اللي هي of the skin. We have a lining of the vagina. We have the genitourinary system, cells lining genitourinary system, urethra. We have the canal, external auricle canal, القناة الخلايا المبطنة لقناة الأذن. We have the hematopoietic cells. All these are continuously dividing and shedded cell. نسميها labile cell. We have another type of cell which is only divide when there is need. Like نسميها stable cell, like the liver cell or hepatocyte. When there is injury to the liver, the remaining viable hepatocyte will get a signal that you should start to divide until restore the normal weight of the liver and the normal shape of the liver. These are the stable cell. And we have a permanent type of cell. This cell does not divide, only during embryogenesis. And after life, when the baby born, this cell never divide, even after to be injured. Like the nerve cell and the muscle cells of the heart. So, hypertrophy occurs when the cell have a limited capacity to divide. يعني ما تقدر تتقسم. So, hypertrophy can be physiological or pathological, and it is caused when there is increased functional demand, or we have a growth factor that increase the size of the cell, or hormonal stimulation. Physiological enlargement of the uterus during pregnancy occurs as a consequence of, for example, estrogen stimulation for smooth muscle and smooth muscle facial redness, smooth muscle hypertrophy and hyperplasia. This is a combined type of hypertrophy. This is a gross appearance of the uterus. On the left side is the normal uterus showing normal mass of a smooth muscle in its wall. On the right is the uterus from a pregnant woman in which a striking increase in the mass of a smooth muscle is evident. This is a normal versus hypertrophied uterine smooth muscle cell. On the left side, there is a small spindle-shaped uterine smooth muscle cell from a normal uterus. شوفوها spindle-shaped cell comes in a bundle, small in size, a nucleus, مثل slit-like nucleus. Compare it with the right side, there is a large, plumpy, hypertrophied, highly smooth. The spindle on the left side become large, rounded, plumpy, hypertrophied smooth muscle from the gravid uterus. This is another gross and histological appearance to the same to the uterus during a pregnancy. This is left ventricular hypertrophy. This is another example. This is a pathological hypertrophy of the cardiac hypertrophy. A number of the, طبعا on the left side هو left ventricle and small هو الكافيتي اللي هو right ventricle on the right side. تشوفون the number of myocardial fiber never increase, but their size can be increased in response to an increased workload. هنا طبعا عندنا احتمال persistent hypertension. They lead to marked thickening of the left ventricle in this patient with hypertension. هذا هو الexample of pathological cellular hypertrophy اللي هو cardiac enlargement ممكن يكون due to hypertension or aortic valve disease cause cardiac enlargement of the wall of the left ventricle. طبعا there is a certain limit is reached beyond which the enlargement of the muscle can no longer compensate for an increased burden. And so when this happens in the heart, degenerative changes will occur in the myocardial fibers. The result is ventricular dilatation and heart failure. الهايبرابلاجيا مثل ما قلنا it occur, it means that increase in the number of the cell population and it occur in cell population that are capable of replication اللي احنا قلنا عليها labile tissue. It can occur concurrently with hypertrophy and often in response to the same stimuli اللي هو ممكن يكون هرمون ممكن يكون growth hormone growth factor sorry. Hyperplasia can be أيضا physiological or pathological. In both situation, الهايبرابلاجيا تحتاج إلى سماد اللي هو الgrowth factor. لازم عندنا growth factor stimulated by growth factor that are produced by a variety of physiological hyperplasia اللي هو hormonal. The proliferation of the glandular epithelium مثلا of the female breast at puberty and during pregnancy ممكن يكون compensatory physiological hyperplasia اللي هو residual tissue grow after removal of the or loss of part of an organ مثل اللي جبنا مثال عليه الليفر هو مذكور بالإكزامبل. Pathological hyperplasia caused by excessive hormone or growth factor stimulation مثلا عندنا hyperplasia هو important response of connective tissue cell in wound healing هذا مهم أيضا هذا نعتبره pathological because we have wound injury يعني صار عندنا cell injury. Hyperplasia اللي associated with viral infection مثلا عندنا human papilloma virus يعطينا skin wart. This is another example of pathological hyperplasia. But the most important point is that hyperplastic process in this condition, still we have hyperplasia, this is adaptive response, should remain under control. If this response is out of control, so it will be changed from the pathological hyperplasia to cancer. So the pathological hyperplasia should remain under control mechanism. So this differentiates the pathological hyperplasia from cancer, in which there is increase in the number of the cell without control mechanism. Endometrial hyperplasia, this is a gross appearance. We see the uterus here is opened or dissected, and there is a prominent fold of endometrium in this uterus, and are an example of endometrial hyperplasia, both of endometrial gland and stroma. Now we come to the atrophy. Atrophy is a shrinkage in the size of the cell by the loss of the cell substance in semil atrophy. If there is a sufficient number of the cell involved, so the entire tissue or organ will be diminished in size and become atrophic. It causes mate, decreased workload, immobilization of the limb, loss of innervation of the nerve supply, diminished blood supply, inadequate nutrition to the person, loss of endocrine stimulation as in menopause, well aging process. This is a gross appearance of atrophy seen in the brain. عندنا طبعا البرين هو عندنا السلساي وعندنا الجيراي. الجيراي هي الفولدز اوف ذا برين ماتيريال، والسلساي اللي هي الجروفز ان بتوين ذا الجيراي. تلاحظون هنا النورمال برين اون ذا الاي اللي هو اون ذا ليفت سايد، وايل الاتروفايد برين اون ذا ليفت سايد هو ات از ا برين اوف 82 ييرز اولد مان وذ اثيروسكلروتيك ديزيز. طبعا اتروفي اوف ذا برين ديو تو ايجينج اند ريديوس بلاد سبلاي، ذير از ا لوس اوف ذا برين سبستنس. تلاحظون الجيراي شرينكج ان ات سايز and narrow the gyri with widening of the sulci. Sulci اللي هي التجاويف اللي ما بين الgrooves ما بين الجيري of the brain. الميتابلاجيا, this is a last adaptive response. It is a reversible change in which one adult cell type is replaced by another adult cell type. يعني شنو؟ يعني خلية تختفي في محاولة من الأورجان إنه يسوي adaptation to the external stimuli. تختفي خلية وتأتي محلها خلية جديدة ليست موجودة بالأصل في هذا المكان, and it is a mature. It is a substitution of one adult cell type by another adult cell type which is not normally present in that situation. In this type of cellular adaptation, the cell type sensitive to a particular stress is replaced by another cell type which is better able to withstand or tolerate. The epithelial metaplasia is exemplified by squamous change that occur in the respiratory epithelium of the habitual cigarette smoker. طبعا lining epithelium is a columnar ciliated epithelium of the trachea and the bronchi. This epithelium is focally or widely replaced by stratified squamous epithelial cell with a survival advantage. شنو يعني survival advantage؟ يعني يتحمل السموكينج والباثوجينز والكارسينوجينز اللي هي بالسموكر, يعني السموك of the cigarette. But when there is a metaplastic change to withstand the stimulus, we will lose important protective mechanism of the host, of the normal cell, which are present normally in that organ. So there is decrease in the mucus secretion and ciliary clearance of the particulate particle will be absent. If it is persistent, it may predispose to malignant transformation within the epithelium. Okay. It is thought that cigarette smoking initially caused squamous metaplasia, and cancer can arise later on in some of these altered foci. Another example is the chronic gastric reflux, in which the normal stratified squamous epithelium of the lower esophagus undergo metaplastic transformation to gastric or intestinal type of columnar epithelium. This slide will show the epithelial metaplasia in a lining epithelium of the trachea, that there is a schematic presentation how the cell change from its normal shape columnar ciliated epithelium above the basement membrane with the gradual change into a squamous metaplastic changes as shown in the histological section below. We have the ciliated columnar epithelium with their nuclei, and the cells are long, tall, ciliated, and transiently they lose their shape and transiently change into a squamous metaplastic tissue. Thank you very much.